In this module, we'll be understanding the basics behind the various network interfaces that you'll find in the operating system. So in order to understand the interface, let us take a very simple example. So let's say there are two computers in a room, and what you want to do is you want to make these two computers share some data with each other. So the simplest way to do this is maybe you can connect the two computers with a LAN cable. So I hope you have seen how two computers can be connected with a LAN cable. So in case you have not seen, this is what it looks like when the connection between two computers or maybe two laptops are made. This is the LAN cable which is connected to a hardware which is there inside the laptop. And one of the important concepts is whenever you want to connect two devices to each other, you need a specific hardware installed in each of those devices. And this is what we call as a network interface card. So this is the RJ45 jack where we put in the LAN cable, and the jack is what we call as a part of a network interface card. So this is what a network interface card looks like. So here is a hardware where you put in the jack, and rest all the interfacing is done by this hardware. So irrespective of mobile devices, tablets, computers, any device which wants to talk to each other needs a dedicated network interface card. And this is what we'll be learning on how we can configure this network interface card in our operating system. So I'll minimize the presentation and let's see how we can configure various interfaces related configuration in Linux. I'll open up the VMware. So this is the Kali Linux machine, and I'll open up the terminal, and the very first command that I'll type is called ifconfig. Ifconfig basically stands for interface configuration, and it allows us to configure our network interface card. I'll press enter, and here you can see that there is first interface called as ETH0. ETH0 basically corresponds to the first network interface card. In my laptop, I only have one NIC card. So this ETH0 corresponds to that particular NIC card. And here are the details related to the NIC card. So here you can see the IP address assigned to that card. Here you can see that there is a hardware address associated with the card, and you have various information related to the multicast, transmit packets, receiving packets, etc. The problem with ETH0 is it is a wired interface. However, in wireless hacking and wireless security, we need an interface which can work in wireless manner. So if I look over here, it is not showing me any Wi-Fi devices in the vicinity. So what I need to do is I need to plug in my wireless adapter. And once I plug in, you will see that there is one more interface which will come when I type ifconfig. Now the reason one more interface will come is because my USB wireless adapter has the capability to talk to other Wi-Fi devices. And as we have learned, when two computers or two devices want to connect to each other, there is an interface which is needed. So I'll connect my USB adapter. And I'll wait for a minute. I'll do ls USB to verify if it is connected. And yes, you can see there is a wireless USB adapter which is connected. So I'll run the ifconfig command again, and let's see if a new interface is up and running. So here you can see there is a new interface which is called WLAN0, which corresponds to the NIC card which is based in the wireless adapter. So as said, once WLAN0 is up, we can work with various activities related to the wireless communication. If you only have ETH0, then you cannot work wirelessly So in order to work on the wireless domain, you need a WLAN 0 interface. So this is all about the network interfacing. One more thing, if I turn the ETH 0 card down, then basically I won't be able to communicate to any other computers except the current one. So it is very important that you have your ETH 0 or whatever interface up and running. Because we have seen in many of the troubleshooting problem where two computers are not able to connect to each other. And the very first thing that we see is whether their network interface card are really up and running. So I hope this lecture has been informative for you, and I would like to thank you for viewing.